It's Monday morning. It's 5:30 in the morning. And with all the birds singing, no, I'm not in an aviary. I just thought it'd be a good time to start a Monday meander. I think I've just said that I've not slept. Didn't get in from work till midnight, and I've not slept. So I thought I'd start a Monday meander and go to sleep when I get home. So many birds. Call me mad if you want, call me crazy if you want. I prefer if you just called it Charlie. But it actually makes quite a lot of sense to be up at stupid o'clock. First of all, I get to have a breakfast at Mackie D's. Fabulous. Even though it's technically not my breakfast, it's more like my tea. Because it's still yesterday and I didn't have anything for my tea. Because I was at work. And I'll be able to catch the non-peak time tube, which, just for your information, Monday to Friday, is, thanks crow in the background. Honestly, London has loads of birds. the peak time for the tube, Monday to Friday in the morning, because there's two peaks. The one in the morning is 6:30 in the morning to 9:30 in the morning. That's everyone going to work. So it costs a little bit more on the tube. But since now it's 5:30, well, it's probably about 5:40 now, I should definitely be able to take you on a journey on a tube train that I have never been on in London. And you might be able to figure out which one that is, probably because I've put it in the title. But yeah, we'll be able to go on that. Because I've never had any reason to. Absolutely no reason. But today I'll be able to do it. Quite looking forward to it, actually. It'd be quite strange. And it'll be strange for them seeing somebody of my ilk to be on their train in the morning. They'll be giving me the eyes up, eyes down. Ew. How come someone on this train who is on it who doesn't work in the financial sector? Another hint. I'm doing all these stupid hints and I've probably called the title something to... I know, I'm thinking of a better title actually, yeah, so hopefully the title has not given it away. You may have also seen that I am not catching the bus, despite the buses being empty. That's because I hate getting the bus. Just walk. That's another bit of advice for you, actually. If you're thinking of coming to holiday in London, you know, if you're coming for a trip into London, is, like last week I said about, if you're going to stay in a hotel, get one on the outskirts of London, so you can just tube in to Central, and that way you'll save an awful lot of money. And the other thing is, if you do tube it into London, and you're in during the weekday, leave it till after 9:30, or do it before 6:30, and that way you won't beat the morning rush hour. There's another rush hour peak, off the top of my head, I've bloody well forgotten it, but that's what Google's for, so Google it. It doesn't cost a lot more, unless you're going through Zone 1, which, if you've been a tourist, you probably will be doing. It's good to know. It'll save you a bit of money, because people often say that London's expensive to live in. And do you know what? It can be if you don't know when to travel, or if you don't know where to go. Honestly, do about even as much as half an hour's research and you'll actually save yourself so much money. London isn't that expensive to live in as you might think. It is a big city, yeah. But if you know where to shop, you know where to go, and you know where to stay, you're sorted. And do not drive into London. Because the biggest drain of money is, of course, time. And time is money. And if you're going to come into London for a little break or something, and you're going to waste it stuck in a traffic jam, well, I'll give you all that stress about where to park or where to go. You don't need any of that. You can use your contactless bank card. Unless you're from a country that doesn't have contactless, then you might have to buy an Oyster card. But I mean, most of Europe and the UK, and I think most countries have got contactless now, aren't they? You know, you don't need an Oyster card. You can go where you want on the tube. And the tube isn't that scary either. Just stand on the right on an escalator. When you're travelling on the tube underground, stand on the right through all the passageways. Very easy. That way, no one will jostle you out the way. I used to work with, because she's left now, but I used to work with someone from America. She was from LA. And she says she loves the fact that in London, people do actually obey the rule of standing on the right, so that if you're not in a massive rush, you can take the nice slow escalator ride down, or if you need to just go, you can just go and you walk on the left. Simple, nice and easy. It's a rule, it works. Every now and again you get someone who disobeys the rule, and you will find that that is when people are not very nice, and they will either barge you out the way or say excuse me, but sternly, because you can't just hog the whole escalator to yourself. There's millions of people using the tube system. So this is just a 6-minute brief of how to save money and how to get around London, and it's as simple as that. It really is. It's not chaos in London. I mean, look at it, it's dead. Oh, it's 5:30 in the morning, but a few little bits of information, a little bit of research, and you'll find that you stay in London, it'll be amazing. But just like every city, if you do bump into a complete and utter bell end, just forget about it, move on, and have a lovely day. Right, I'm really looking forward to my Mackey D's now. McDonald's Mackey D's, glowing like a golden beacon. I'll tell you, orange signs are always the best ones, you know. Zebra crossings with the Belisha beacons and McDonald's signs. Two of the best orange lights in the world. Even on traffic lights, people go faster through yellows, you know. Yellow is a place to go. This is the face of disappointment, and me being quite possibly being the most stupidest person to be walking around the whole of Shepherd's Bush right now. Me, today, this early on a Monday, for the rest of the week actually, I am idiot of the week. Guess what I have done? And you may have recognised it from what I'm wearing. Even the police should just lock me up for my stupidity. Now, it's my understanding, and so is yours as well, that when you need to purchase something and when you need to go somewhere, and I've already spoken about them, you need some kind of method of payment. Yeah. I've got all the way to Shepherd's Bush, put the wrong coat on, haven't I? My bank cards, my Oyster card, everything is in that yellow coat. I can't believe it. I've just been saying about yellow's a place to go, and I'm not wearing it, and I've got my bank cards at home. I am such a moron. I've walked all this way, so I have to go back home. Get it? Now I'm going to have to get the bus. I know I might hit the peak time charge on the tube. Oh my word! I am so annoyed with myself right now. All this way, I can't believe I didn't check first. Why didn't I check? Oh, good grief. Oh, I am such an idiot. Oh, I can't.
Two, three, seven. To White City.
Well, it's 6:10. What's that saying about best made plans?
Goldhawk Road Station.
I can't believe it. I mean, I'm going to wait the peak time and everything now. I'm going to not go to McDonald's now. Well, not this side anyway. I'll wait till I get into London, central London rather. I can't believe I'm so stupid today. I mean, I don't even normally wear a coat. Do I? You've seen me in the garden. It can be like 1 to 2 degrees. I walk to work without a coat because I don't feel the cold. I only wear a coat because in central London I'm sick to death of people looking at me as if I'm crazy.
237 to White City.
Well, obviously I'm walking down the street with a camera, but you know what I mean, don't you? So anyway, let's start all over again.
Shepherd's Bush Road.
Such a numpty. Now, at this point, I don't know how it works. So I've got £6.80 on my card. Now, it'll be in the peak time by the time I get to bank. So does that mean that I'm still going to be charged the peak rate because I'm travelling through the peak time? I don't know. But I'm going to find that out for myself today after 9 years living in London. 9 years. Look, stand on the right, walk on the left. Obviously, at this time, absolutely no one is walking anywhere. Well, to get off the escalator.
See.
I am such a moron. I'm still really miffed with myself for that. To make matters worse, I'm walking around with a selfie stick today for steadiness. Someone's just lost the change. Not me. I think someone's just lost the change on their escalator. So if the escalator goes off at Shepherd's Bush, now we know why.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen.
Got a gale of wind.
Going down the tube.
Oh, it's so windy down here, just a little bit of control of that.
Yeah, so that'll be fun on a Monday, won't it, for people of Shepherd's Bush.
Ladies and gentlemen, London Underground regret to inform you that the escalator at Shepherd's Bush is out of order due to someone dropping their change.
Oh, it was so windy. The lady who just ran behind me then, and then there was somebody who was with her. I thought that was lost. It was so sweet, bless them. I said, oh, do you need any help? And they did the proper bow and everything. No, I'm fine, thank you. Gosh, I tell you what, if everyone in London was as nice as that, I tell you, I think everyone would live in London. But anyway, they're not. I suppose after I've lived in London for 10 years, next year, I suppose I'll have to do something special, won't I? Do I get an award off the mayor? Probably not. It's useless, this mayor we've got at the minute. Absolutely useless. I suppose that's a bucket as a celebration, won't I? I've not been in Shepherd's Bush for 10 years. But I've lived in London for 10 years. I lived in Hillenden, didn't I, for the first 5. Blah, 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 blah. Now just waiting for the tube. It's never this quiet. I sort of liked the echo then. I've never heard that noise before. It's usually so loud down here. It's so quiet. 6 minutes? Gosh. Trains at this time, people would be pulling their hair out at peak time if there was a train every 6 minutes. That'd be terrible. Anyway, I still feel a bit of a twit holding a selfie stick, but it's helping the steadiness of the camera, so what can you do? Oh, good. Just had a thought. The bus that I was on recently, now I'm on the tube, it's dead quiet because obviously it's against the law to talk on the tube. I should start my own business of selling tissues and breath mints in the morning. I'd be a millionaire. I really would. I don't see what the difficulty is not brushing your teeth or breath freshening in the morning. It's out of order. It stinks. Not always. Just today.
This is Central Line train to Epping.
Just to clarify, not me. Someone else. Don't know who.
She'll go around and ask.
Just had to get off that train. God, it wasn't just because of someone's disgust-worthingly horrific halitosis.
Hey, for goodness sake, mouthwash. Brush your teeth, do you know what I mean? But also, I'm hungry, so I'm going to go to Macadies. It was just getting ridiculous. It's not always like that at all. Yeah, because I could just jump on the Northern Line after I got to Macadies, because I'm just too hungry. Because that's what you want in the morning, isn't it? You know? This time in the morning, I want a proper breakfast. I want fat, salt, sugar, caffeine. No one's waking up at 6 o'clock, half five in the morning, wasn't it, originally. No one's getting up at that time of the morning and going, do you know what I want? Salad. No. I don't want guacamole and some crappy bread. I want a proper breakfast. I'm gonna get one. I was just talking about pointless food, and they had salad advertised because, you know, I was saying how stupid and useless to eat carnies. Is the Mayor of London at the minute. He thinks that if he removes fast food adverts on the tube, it will stop people wanting fast food. Well, I'm here to tell you it didn't work. Okay, right now I'm wanting McDonald's. Yeah, it charged me £2.40, so I've been charged the full rate. I'm specifically going to McDonald's and I'm on the tube. There you are, said it can. Your stupid ban on fast food ads has failed catastrophically, and it's just losing money for the underground. There you are. Can you tell I'm hungry? Now I'm happy. Macadies have started doing the paper straws, haven't they? Which is really weird because this isn't the first time, but I remember the first time I got the straw out and I thought that the plastic was extra thick. And I realised, oh, paper straw. Do you know what, actually? Since it's quite an alright morning, I might just walk to Bank Station. If I can find the map thing so I know that I'm going the right way, because the last thing I want to do now is to be going the wrong way, isn't it? So, I need to find the, there it is, it's over there, look. Where is it? It is, I can't see. It's behind me. I'm sorry, I've got no change, I'm sorry. And I really am. Yeah, so I'll be able to check on the map now to make sure I'm going the right way. Look both ways. Oh, I hate when people do that. Oh. Is there a bin? There isn't a bin. Well, I'll put it down there. Fucking people smashing glass. Fucking idiots. Anyway, there's the sign. Right, I'm too far away from it. I need to go that way because I'm pretty sure that I need to go to, oh no, I need to go to Woburn, I think. So I think I need to go up that way, I think. So that is, north is that way, is what I meant. And north, on the floor, look, says it's that way. So I think I need to go down that way, I think. But then it says Urban, New Oxford Street, up that way. I'm sure I need to go to Urban. Sod that, on second thought, so I'm just going to have a Macadies and get back on the tube. I feel better for that, I really do. Double sausage and egg muffin, ash brown, Coke Zero, sloppy turtle, be impressed with my healthiness. Well, yeah, I was going to walk around, but I was too hungry. I just wanted to sit down and enjoy my Macadies. Now I'm just going to jump on the Northern Line and go to Bank. How many stops? Where is it? Bank. As embankment, but I just want a bank, not embankment. Where is it? Oh, I'll find it. Where is it? I bet you can all see it, can't you? Is it even on here? It will be.
I should stop talking and concentrate. Just had a nice little chat with a person who waits on the underground. I've just said that after 9 years living in London. Northern Line, still a complete blooming mystery to me. The irony, you know, a northerner getting completely confused on the Northern Line. Well, anyway, total silence, like, it's a full escalator of people. Anyway, so the Northern Line splits and from Kent, you got the... Oh, she's just told me, and I've completely forgotten already. There's the Kennington branch and there's the bank. There's the Charing Cross branch and the bank branch. And now I'm on the wrong one, so I just had to get back on the central line again. Oh well. At least I'm happier now I've been fed. And, I'm about to be very naughty and go on the no entry sign, but I know this is the quickest way to the central line. It's one of the secrets of the underground. What it means is that at peak time, if a train was stopping, it'd be very annoying for all the people getting off of me walking this way. Like now, for instance, all these people would be pouring off the train, and if I'd come down at that precise moment, it would have been very annoying for them all. So all these people, see what I mean? And you just don't want to put yourself in that situation.
Someone's written freedom there on the central line bit. Does that mean freedom in general, or is freedom only available in West Ryslip, Ryslip Gardens, Ryslip, what's it, South? And Norfolk. You shall never know. This guy behind me is watching the Big Bang Theory on his phone.
He's not laughed. Is that because the Big Bang Theory is just not funny? It's one of the funniest things I've seen in ages. And the most pointless journey of the world ever. And that guy didn't even smile, not even once. I mean, you've got to use your data usage up somehow, I suppose. Maybe it's coming to the end of his tariff or something. But it was just so funny. Oh, I'm minding the gap. I'm walking the wrong way. I mean, apart from a few sassy slow bends from Sheldon, I never really got into the Big Bang Theory. I never thought it was that funny. I found the rip-off videos that people have done on YouTube more funny, so that I don't actually have to watch a full episode of Big Bang Theory. I never get into it. And I can't believe it ran longer than Friends. I don't think it was on the best channel in the UK anyway. It was only on E4 or something, you know. It wasn't put on normal channel 4 like Friends was. Yes. If you've got to tap out, tap back in again to use this bloody tube line. Yeah, so today I'm dubbing the line I've never used before for absolutely no reason. And I've walked down here before, but it's always been shut. Look at that, look at that distance. I'm gonna actually walk down it. Or should I just get the travelator? No, I'm gonna walk. So pointless information for you. I'm going to have a bit of a meander. This is like the... Well, it isn't like the... It's an actual fact. It's the shortest tube line on the whole of the underground. Only runs Monday to Saturday. It's closed on a Sunday. Is it closed on Saturdays as well? I've forgotten. I think it is. Not too sure. Oh, well, Google it. Wow, this is a long walk. And it's on a slope as well. It feels like, almost like it was built on a slope to hurry people up. Not that busy though, for this time of the morning. It's quite quiet, isn't it? Good grief, what a walk. Yeah, so the Waterloo and City Line's the shortest tube line. It's only got two stops. And, well, not even two stops really, is it? Because if you get on one end, you get off at the other, and that's it. There's no stops in between. Oh, it's really weird. So small. Apparently the trains are the same as the Central Line, except there's only three carriages instead of six. So it's a smaller train as well. How cute! It's really weird. Oh, it's busier than what I thought it'd be. I know it's got more than three carriages. It's, four. There you are. I don't know. Oh, if you want more information, speak to Jeff Marshall about it. It's not quite the same. They've got these little armrest things on. Luxury. They don't have these on the Central one. In case you get lost. A 3 minute journey. And it's so clean. But then it was closed yesterday, so I've tried to clean it. But it, you can actually see how much cleaner it is. I'm gonna get a Waterloo. I'll have a meander around there. Tube line. This is so weird. It feels like a Central Line train, but it isn't, and it's really weird. I'm gonna get rid of this selfie stick. I feel really self-conscious with this selfie stick. Now I'm at the other end. It's so surreal, it really is. Waterloo is London's busiest station, and this is the quietest thing ever. The same advert runs through the entire carriage. I wonder if that's on purpose. Maybe I've just timed it. Oh, look at that. That's one for the train spot, isn't it? Anyway, I'm going to have a meander around Waterloo because it's been a while since I've been round here. So have a bit of an ogle, shall we? It's Monday Meander. And all you've seen me do so far is me talk to you. And I'm sure you're watching this trying to look at some sights of London. Oh yeah, it is open on a Saturday. It's just Sunday that it's closed. Oh gosh. Oh, God's sake. Can't find my oyster annoying. Barriers at one end and not the other. Could have walked right past that. Yeah, I think it's very few stations on the London Underground don't have physical barriers. Very, very few. So that can catch you out. So always remember to tap in and tap out whenever you use the Underground. So you tap in and you tap out. On the DLR, there's no barriers at all, so that catches me out a few times. And if you forget, you get charged the full rate. And it's very expensive, so don't forget. And usually there's barriers to remind you, and I nearly walked past them. Anyway, we're at Waterloo Station now, London's busiest station. It's madness, Waterloo Station. Madness. Very easy to get lost. However, I still prefer Waterloo Station to Euston. Can't stand Euston Station. Bin. Right. What makes Waterloo even more busy is that it's generally just a shopping centre with a great big bloody train station running through the middle of it. Just. Oh. Let's have a look around Waterloo. It's making me out to be a liar, but Waterloo Station is just 30 train platforms of madness. At peak time, one train stuffs up. Oh my word, that is it. It's bedlam. Absolute madness. Yo sushi. If I win the lottery, okay, I will definitely be in there forever. I love sushi. I think if you ever go abroad, I think I'd love to go to Japan and get some proper good sushi. Yeah. But much like Adina Monsunov, I'm absolutely fabulous. If they're going to keep the food coming round, I'm going to keep eating it. I'd stay there till I've eaten the entire Pacific Ocean. I just know I would. I love this mezzanine platform thing. It's really, at this time when all the shops are shut, it's really nice. I keep forgetting how early it is. Obviously, none of the shops are open. It's only just coming up to 7:30. Like I said, Waterloo Station is just on top of its massive busyness for travelling wherever you need to go in the country. It's also just a big, massive shopping centre. And there's just bazillions loads of shops. Old window. And Paper Chase. It's really sad about Paper Chase having to close stores and whatnot. But I think it could be run better. It's got loads of possibilities. I just think the owners have just run out of ideas, I think. Waterloo East Station. I don't even know what that means. Is that even more platforms? I think it is. I think it is. It's just silly. How the hell do you get out of here, actually? I think I left Waterloo Station once, and I can't remember how to get out of it now. I'm going down an escalator now. Good grief. Oh, way out. There we go. It's this way. I've already been this way once. It's not really a meander round, is it? It's not really a Monday Meander. I'm just going round in circles. Waterloo Road. I think I'm going the wrong way. I think. I seem to be going down another escalator. But I've just been forced to. I feel a bit like a sheep right now. It must be the way out. Yeah, I can see daylight. Oh, that's good. Now I remember where I am. This is actually the same exit I left before, actually. Yeah. I left, then I had to get back on the tube. Macadies! I can't remember Macadies been there. It's always been there. Well, I've already been once, so I don't want another one. I've extended my selfie stick in the most inappropriate fashion. But there's the old Vic. There's the shard in the background. Still seem to have found my way near the shard. It's through the tree there, can you see it? And look, there we are, look. I'll see if I can find anything worth of note in Waterloo. I'm getting rid of this selfie stick because I look like a twat. So we might as well start with the old Vic, haven't we? It's a theatre that's been going since 1818. So just a few years then. And it's just a very old theatre. There you are. At the minute it's showing the American clock. I'm walking up now. I mean, the places in London are really tightly packed together because, I mean, as you could see in the background, there was the shard. Everything's really tightly packed together in London, so London might seem big, but really it's not. It's really like, after the Great Fire of London, if they'd have actually gone ahead with plans to make it all, you know, like a spiral, they had like a grid in mind, you know, like much like in America, it would have been much easier to get around. Oh, but then again, would it? Because we have roundabouts here, but you know what I mean. But no, they're just like, oh, just build it as we go. So it just resulted in this mishmash of confusion. Something got really windy down here. Let's see if we can find something else of interest. Just nearly fell on some uneven pavement. Sidewalk. Look at that! That, over there, is an actual queue for a bus. And not the usual London rabble. Look! Queues! I am shocked! Shocked! An actual queue and not a rabble of people. That might all change once the bus stops. Yes, it's very, very old round here. As you can see, until you get to these awful throw-up buildings. apparently Waterloo got
quite a significant few bombs during the war, resulting in that sort of behaviour.
See what I mean about everything being tight together? There's Waterloo where I am, I'm there. And look, there's the BFI IMAX, National Theatre, ITV Studios, well, one of their studios anyway. So everything's really close together. And Oxo Tower.
So everything's close together, so you're never really lost. And there's always maps everywhere. So there you go. Nice and easy.
Where was the Oxford Tower?
Sorry?
Oxford Tower.
Oxford Tower is there.
Oxford Tower?
Yeah.
Okay, here we are.
Oh, no probs.
Thank you.
No probs.
It's a nice mosaic, isn't it?
And there's one on the other side, but it's not as interesting. I liked that one better. Oh, there's another one.
I don't know why the Mona Lisa is also looking like that with the boobs out. But anyway,
that is not an accurate description of where the buses are. You're not going to find the Mona Lisa with the boobs out. With the backs. South Park Centre, BFI, National Theatre, London Eye. Where should I go? Shall I go in the London Eye? It's early, it'll be quiet. Shall I do it? Let's see if I can. Don't get your ropes up. I'll have to see you first. But I might just do that.
I wonder what time it opens. Probably not open now because it's really early, but if it opens soonish, I might go on the big wheel.
There's a bloody great big river there, and that's where the duck wants to be. How rude.
It appears, probably because it's term time, you know, kids are at school, but the London Eye is asleep until 11. It's currently just 8 o'clock. It's a lazy eye. Well, I'll have to wait around 3 hours, so that might happen, it might not. I don't know how long this video is going to be, so judge for yourself how long the video is if you think I hung around for 11 o'clock. Bearing in mind I've not slept. And I will have been up for more than 24 hours by that point. Such a lovely day, look. The sun is on that horrible house. And there's that. I've forgotten what it is. I always get confused between MI5 and MI6. I always get confused. But anyway, that's where James Bond lives. Or works. Yeah, I can't believe it. Wake up till 11 o'clock. Oh well. The London Dungeons here. Well, that's another tourist attraction. Get to learn about the history of London and stuff. Yeah, everything's still closed. I mean, obviously, it's March. All the kids are at school. I mean, during the summer. And at Christmas time, all this will probably all be open by now. Or getting ready to open at least. I don't know what is. Why do people insist on running by the river? Let the river run. Let the people run by the river, even. Then they got run over by a big green road sweeper thing there. There's Big Ben, that's not quite very big at all. It's coming back to run me over. Failed once, wants to do it again. I should sue! I decided to get a Pret. Got a latte.
And, yeah, I shall have a bit of a meander. And see if there's anything else. Obviously, I've walked out of Waterloo now. And, just have a mooch. See if there's anything else I can see. More information would be nice for you, wouldn't it? I've ended up in central London again, haven't I?
Right, what have I done so far? I've gone on the Waterloo and City Line for the first time in my life. That was weird. I was in the old Vic Theatre. And we might, but bad looks of it now, not today, we might go on the London Eye when it's awake. Yeah. You see, at the minute, the London Eye is sponsored by Coca-Cola, but you'd think Specsavers would have tapped into the market, wouldn't you? You know what I mean? I think it'd have been a great sponsor by Specsavers. Because then they could have put a big pair of glasses on it. That'd have been fun. Oh, gosh, this coffee's delicious. It's the best coffee I've bought in weeks. It's the only coffee I've bought in weeks. Oh, it's bloody lovely though. Yeah, look, there's all the busy people all at work. It's 8 o'clock, but I mean, I'm sure lots of people are already there. But it's my day off, which is great. Lovely. That's the riverboat stop there. Oh, I could get on the riverboat, couldn't I? I'll see how much it is, because I don't think... I always get confused if you can pay on your Oyster or not, but I'll have a look. Oh dear, I should stop promising, or... Well, I'm not promising. I should stop suggesting, shouldn't I? Because so far I've been let down by a lazy eye. And, yeah. Oh, well, we walked over the Westminster Bridge together, which is nice. It's a really old bridge. This is the one with the funny reflections. When the sun comes through the holes, it looks, it makes a rude picture on the floor. These are all the people on the way to work. So busy, 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 busy. Not yet though, because it's only 8:05. Oh, look, a proper poem. I don't think everyone's ever recorded this. William Wordsworth, 1770, 1850, composed upon Westminster Bridge, 3rd of September, 1802. Oh, not very long ago then. Earth has not anything to show more fair. Dull would be of soul who would pass by. A sight so touching in its majesty. The city now doth like a garment wear the beauty of the morning silent bare. Ships, towers, domes, theatres, and temples lie upon unto the fields and to the sky. All bright and glittering in the smokeless air, never did sun more beautifully steep. In his first splendour, valley, rock, or hill, ne'er saw I. Never felt a calm so deep. Exclamation mark. Oh, good grief. Even hundreds of years ago, they was putting unnecessary exclamation marks. Anyway, the river glideth at his own sweet will. Dear God, exclamation mark. The very houses seem asleep, and all that mighty heart is lying still. Exclamation mark. Oh, lovely William Wordsworth. Okay, then. I have absolutely no idea of these words, and... Old English is very difficult to understand sometimes. Very difficult. I mean, doth. We don't say doth anymore. And we don't say ne'er. Although I want to know what... Is that never? Is that never? Because if that means never, I am so going to say ne'er more often. That sounds like someone from East Ullo saying no. It's like, ne'er. Oh well, poetry, whatever. I wonder if there's more in the next lamppost. See, I mean, you've got poetry by William Wordsworth, whatever it was, and then you've got just got the standard graffiti on the rest of the bridge. I mean, I really don't care that Anna Lucia was here in 2016. I don't know who you are, I don't know who you think you are, and I don't know who all you people are either, with your pointless vandalism. You know? Oh my word. YouTube.com. Someone's actually plugged their own titting YouTube channel on the bridge. I've never seen anything so grotesque in my life. It's grass. Subscribe, comment, mate. Shameful. Shameful. I mean, now that I've seen that, probably someone's put their own hashtag on here or something. Ridiculous. See, the pigeons aren't bothered. You know what I mean? Stop vandalising the perches. I'm sure they poo over everything, don't they? Let's see if the pier is open. And it doesn't look it, does it? It looks shut. But people do go to work by boat, which is sweet. But I'll see the opening times. 11 o'clock. Well, okay then. We're coming up to one of the many war memorials. We'll have a look at that. And we'll read it out. There's loads of names, many, many, many names. And I'll see if there's any that's close to my name. There might be. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. Winston Churchill. So this is one of the memorials. There's another one there, look. This probably comes across as really flat on YouTube, but it's actually all 3D. It's all built up and everything. And there's a reason why there's like a story that goes from left to right. The engravings on the plaques on the elevation feature from left to right, the Bristol Beaufighter, the Bristol Blenheim, the Gloucester Gladiator, and the Bolton Pole Defiant, and further along this side, the Hawker Hurricane designed by Sydney Camp. And we'll come back to names. See if there's any names that I know on there. Yeah, so look. History. And it's not that long ago, really, is it? So that's that one. And then there's this one. The Battle of Britain. Oh, it says something there. This monument was unveiled by HRH, the Prince of Wales, on Sunday, 18th of September 2005, in the presence of survivors of the few. And there you go. Send it to the History Channel. The Battle of Britain. Here you are. If you're at school, here's something to copy down. It's probably written on Google somewhere, isn't it? There you are. There you are. Pause and you'll be able to read it, because that's a lot to read out. And I don't think I'll do it justice. I just want to find someone with the same last name as me. Seeing if there's any history in my family of us being a sergeant or anything. I pretty much doubt it. I mean, right, I don't even know what letter we're up to there. We're up there, the B's. I'm way off, aren't I? Yeah, I found a Fleming. Correctly spelt as well with one M, but I don't know what P-O means. Is it private officer? I don't know. R-D-S Fleming. Or is it just D-S? I don't know. What does P-O mean? I had to Google it, and it means petty officer. So now I know. And it's not just Brits, look, it's people from other, like, Barbados, Belgium, and Jamaica, Newfoundland, New Zealand, Poland, all people fighting to keep us safe from Nazi Germany back in the day. Yeah, so that's a bit of history. Come and see it, you know, there's loads of history in London, and let's see if I can see something else now. I think I've shown you this before, actually. Probably did. I hope that was used legitimately and no numpty has just chucked it in, because that is out of order. Oh, you can use your oyster, look. touching and touch out your concept. Yeah, so you can use your Oyster on the riverboat. I always forget if you can or you can't, but you can. I really want to go in, but everything opens so late and I'm getting tired now. Oh, well, there you are, more information. Wanted. There we are. Do you recognise any of these people? Oh, look, I've turned into a public helping service now. What's he done? Burglary. Right. We've focused on him long enough. There was somebody else a second ago. Burglary. None of them are pretty face. 18? He looks older than 18. He can't be 18. He looks awful for 18. I do realise now that I'm just slagging off wanted criminals. And look at the state of that burglary. He's so going to be someone's bitch in prison. Isn't he? Look at that face! Oh dear. You see, this is what happens when they get rid of Crime Watch. The police are reduced to stupid signs on sides of vans with people probably not even looking at it. So I'm doing a public service here right now. Oh, look, there's the standard one look where they always do that looking down the nose effect. If I was taking pictures of criminals, I'd take sneaky pictures when they didn't know they was getting the pictures taken. Theft of a motor vehicle. Well, just tell us what kind of vehicle. Was it a tractor? Was it a bus? A crane? A car? A van? A lorry? A bike? What? What's this one? Burglary, breach of supervision order. There we go. So, if you feel like dubbing someone in, there you go. We'll do one more, then I'm going. Do we think the next one's going to be another daft picture, like looking down the nose, thinking they're clever? Oh no, gosh no. It's Mr. Big Eyes with the big bags under his eyes. Burglary. Dragos Marcian Goric? Goic? Whatever. Like I said in a previous video, life is so short, why waste it making people unhappy? Don't understand people who want to be so mean. I don't get it. Of course, we'll never be in a world of peace, ever. People will fight and die for it. But there's always going to be somebody who thinks they're amazing and just cause a load of trouble, and it's not right. Catch a boat here today! Exclamation mark. Well, I want to, but I can't because it's closed. I was hoping that boat was called Betty Bay. It's called Retty Bay. That one's Joanne B. And that one's Provada.
Lovely.
And I've just done something disgusting. I think it's like the remnants of someone's kebab from the weekend. Taking a film of someone having the picture taken. Oh no, there's a boat. In 3 minutes. It's a Battersea. Ah. Well, what was that reading then? I thought people went to work on the boats. That's silly. I must have been looking at something touristy.
Yeah, there is. There's a boat in 3 minutes.
And I'm the only person.
I'm the only person.
You watch, there's going to be somebody else now. But if there's somebody else on the boat, that'd be Brill, won't it? Imagine if I had the own boat to myself, though. Do not use this door.
Why? What'll happen if I use that door?
Is this me? Is this me? I don't know. There's hardly anyone on that boat. Oh, it must be me.
I hope I've got enough money on my Oyster card. I've only just realised. Oh, I'll be real cross with myself if I am.
Pockets and on notices around the outside deck. The next pier is Battersea Power Station. Disembark here for Battersea Park. When leaving, please ensure you take all your belongings with you. Contactless and Oyster users are reminded to touch out to avoid paying an incorrect fare.
seats are dead comfy. Don't want to get up now.
If you want to stay on and get back into town, that's fine, because we don't get back to Westminster, so...
Oh, okay then. Alright, yeah, all right, lovely. Cheers, thanks. Cheers. No, well, there we are then. Stay on, I'm comfy. Sit closer to the middle then. Because there's not that much, there's not much at Battersea Power Station anyway, which is what I've just been showing you with the four big towers.
Any passengers for London Eye Waterloo? See the front of the boat, please.
I hope you enjoyed that. I don't know, but I have no idea how much that cost because I didn't have enough on my Oyster card, but you can use your bank card. So contactless again, which is something else I didn't know you could use. But it's great and it's really nice. So I'm back at the lazy sleeping eye again. I think I'm pretty much done. I think I'll leave it there. So that was a bit of a meander. I just realised I had three different modes of transport, didn't I, in this video. Got on a bus, got on a tube, got on a boat. But not quite a big wheel. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please scratch them in the comment section down below. What do you think to these Sunday? It is technically to me, isn't it? Monday Meander videos, not Sunday outside. Although they are quite similar, aren't they? So if you come to London, it's really quite easy, really. And I know it can look as if it's scary, you know, because it's busy and obviously the media doesn't help. You know, there was that doom and gloom. It's really not that bad at all. Come visit London. It's nice. There's always something to do. And as I've said so many times before, I've been down here for 9 years. I've lived in London for 9 years and there's still stuff I've not done. So when you're being a tourist, if you don't want to do all the usual stuff, I know many people do want to do all the same sort of things. They want to see Big Ben and then they want to see where the Queen lives and then they want to see the usual stuff. But if you don't want to do that and if you want to do something different, there is different stuff to do, so do it. And you might actually enjoy it more because you might find that there's fewer people there to bump into and you can just enjoy yourself and have a nice time, whether you're on your own or with a family or a couple, whatever. There's always stuff to do, always. I'm not too sure how much it charged me for that trip on the boat, but what I understand is it's not too bad. I have been on the boat before, but only once, and I can't remember which it was, but it wasn't very much at all. It really wasn't. So yeah, you enjoyed the video. Scrass, which is subscribe, comment, rate and share. Pardon me. Or share, comment, rate and subscribe. Whichever order you want it. So from me and the sleeping eye, bye! As usual, I never seem to say goodbye properly, do I? I should add some extra information. When you use your Oyster card and contactless on your bank card, you still get the daily cap of, I forget how much it is, but I think it's £8. So if you keep using the tube and the bus, it'll cap you off as soon as you wait the daily rate. Because back in the day, there used to be a day card you could buy. I think you can still get it, but it's too much of a faff. So most people now just use the bank card or the Oyster card. I'm pretty sure I'm right in saying that does not include if you use the riverboat, because obviously that is a luxury, whereas bus and tube is public transport, if you know what I mean. I'm really sure that you'll still get charged more if you use the riverboat. Just thought I'd put that in. You know what, also, before we go, I just want to add this as well. Now, I hate talking about political stupid stuff on my videos. But you know when Donald Trump was trying to make out that in the UK knife crime's just as bad as gun crime in America? This is controversial, but I'll never forget one of the stupid speeches that Donald Trump made. And it went along the lines of this. I'm walking back over Westminster Bridge again. It was, there's a prestigious hospital in London, used to be prestigious, but there's blood all over the floor, and the knife crime in London is a problem, blah, 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 blah. It's a hospital, okay? They're a prestigious hospital. You know when he was like, I think it's when he repealed all that Obamacare and all this, that and the other, and it's, a hospital is meant to have sick people in. There's no such thing as a prestigious hospital. You know, I mean, are people meant to have prestigious illnesses in a prestigious hospital? You know, only acceptable diseases and disorders in this hospital, please. We are a prestigious hospital. It makes no sense. So stupid. And what people don't seem to know is, like, the NHS, right? Of course it's not perfect, but do you know what? I'm bloody glad it's there. I've had to use it very little. But to be brutally honest, without it, earlier on in the video I mentioned about someone from America, and she was telling me how people with epilepsy actually wear wristbands to say don't call an ambulance because they can't afford the ambulance fee. That blew my mind. That just shows how out of order it is, and I can't believe that you had to think of such a thing if you're in need of care. And I think something like the charge for the ambulance was something like $1,000 or something. It's outrageous! Oh my word! It's just... No, so... People who... I mean, the dirt, you know what I mean? I mean, the media make out worse than it actually is, obviously, and stuff. And politicians use it as a political tool to win votes. Then as soon as they get the votes and they get in and they start, like, cutting services and this, that, and the other. And these jobs there that are probably unnecessary. Everyone in the UK loves the NHS. And yes, mistakes happen, but they happen everywhere, you know? Yeah, sometimes people are... not quite as good as nurse or doctor as they should be, but that happens everywhere. It's not a reflection of the NHS on the whole at all. So I have huge respect for the NHS, as probably 99.999% of the people do. It's only the very rich 1% who don't get it, like the Conservative government. Anyway, so there you go. Hey, before I get on the bus to get home, that's my bus stop there, but that's not my bus. My bus is 148. I can get all the way to Shepherd's Bush from Westminster. Parliament Square, and it shows you all the statues of the people and places. So Westminster Abbey, St Margaret's, Nelson Mandela, George Canning, Sir Robert Peel. Have a good read. There you are. Can you see it all? Yeah. And this is the Jubilee Walkway, which is like a big zigzaggy walkway. So here, and it all goes round like other side to the river and whatnot. That's where it's looking. It's even all in Braille. And gosh. Well, now I really am going now because my battery is on critical. Critical. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scress, and I'll see you when I see you.